Okay, this question was asked in GATE 2012. You can see the question, you can read once. This is basically a flanged section that you can see here, and some dimensions are given. Okay, so these are the dimensions. You can see the width of the wave is given, 325. Overall depth is given and the effective depth is given. Total area of steel, that is 4000 millimeter, that will be required. This is under reinforced section, and the neutral axis depth is greater than 100 millimeter. That means the neutral axis is passing somewhere from at this level. Okay, so this is a link questions, two questions actually, this one and this one. In the first questions, they have asked the value of xu, that is the actual neutral axis depth in millimeter as per limit state method of IS 456-2000, and the second one, in the second question, they have asked the moment capacity. Okay, so we are moving on. If we closely observe the stress diagram, before going to that, let's see if we can split the original section into two parts for our convenience only. Okay, so here we are getting the first part. Okay, that means we are cutting this section from here, and another one is this one. Okay, so this is our section 1 and this is our section 2. Now if we look into the first one, the first section, then what you can see, it is a purely rectangular section. Okay, now if we work with a rectangular section, then what we have, it's very famous. That means in two dimensional figure, in the stress block, this is the stress block I am talking about, we will be getting a force that is of magnitude 0.36 fck into xu for the 2D diagram only. Now if you want to get the original force, actual force, then we have to multiply the width of the beam, that is width of the section, this one. Okay, this is the first part. And the second part, you can see, as the neutral axis is going somewhat from here, okay, so we are not getting the parabolic part in the stress diagram. In the stress diagram, it will be purely rectangular. So for any kind of rectangular, what only we need, that is the stress value, that is 0.45 fck, okay, and the thickness or the depth of the flange, that is 100 millimeter. Okay, so firstly, if we calculate for the limit state method, what we have to do to get the actual neutral axis, we have to just equate the compressive force and the tensile force. So for the first part, the compressive force is 0.36 fck xu into the width of the first section, that is 325. Okay, plus for the second section, for the rectangular part, for this part, the force, whatever force is acting over here, that is 0.45 into fck into the width of the section, this one, from here to here, this is 100. And if we multiply the width of this particular portion, that is 675, from where it is coming, the overall the width was 1000 millimeter. If we just subtract to 325, it will become 675. So if we multiply, we will get the force. So this one is compressive, this one is also compressive. So this has become our total compressive force. And for the tensile force, it's very familiar, I think, that is 0.87 Fy into Ast. Now if you put Fck as 25 and Fy as 415, we will see that it is coming, the XU value is coming as 234.13 millimeter. The XU limiting value we can find from, for Fe 415 grade of steel, XU limiting by D, it is 0.48. So D we know, that is the effective width, that is 570. If we multiply, it will become 273.6 millimeter. So it is checked, that is under reinforced section, it's fine. Okay. So the answer here, you can see the closest answer we are getting 34.13 millimeter, and the closest answer will be 236.3 millimeter. Okay. Now moving on to the second question, second part. For the second part, we have to calculate the moment. Now once we have got the forces, it is very easy to find the moments. See, as we know already, we have divided the whole structure into two parts, part 1 and part 2. Okay, so for the first part, our force is already we have got, that is 0.36 Fck XU into 325, that is the width of the section, into the lever arm distance. This is the level of reinforcing steel, and this is from where this compressive force will be acting. From top compression, so the extreme compression fiber, this distance is as we know as 0.42 XU, and the effective depth is small d. So this distance, that means from here to here, actually the lever arm distance will be d minus 0.42 XU. This is for the first part. For the second part, interestingly, the force is 0.45 Fck into 100 into 675. Already we have computed. Now this force will be acting from the CG of this section. This thickness, as you can remember, it was 100, okay. So this is again your effective depth. So the lever arm distance in this particular case will be d minus 50. So we can multiply d minus 50 with it. So this will be our total moment. Now if you put XU as 236.13 millimeter as we got, and D as 570 millimeter, then we can have our moment capacity as 720.25 kilonewton meter. If you see the options, the closest one is, our answer is 720.25 kilonewton meter, and the closest answer will be 717.0 kilonewton meter. Thank you.